Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about reverberation and pressure in our rooms. A lot of people get these issues confused. I hope some of these examples and definitions will help. Pressure, we all are familiar with. That's all that unwanted bass boom, low frequency booms, room modal issues. It's always below 100 cycles. That's the area, kind of the dividing line that we use, because above 100 cycles, treatment is a lot easier. Then below 100 cycles, a lot less square footage coverage, a lot less density, a lot less mass to treat those issues. So that's how we define unwanted pressure issues. Reverberation, on the other hand, is all that energy above that, that mainly, I mean, it does concern the lower frequencies, but for purposes of discussion, we'll take the energy all above that, you know, and that's the time it takes for the energy to decay in the room. So we have pressure, which is a buildup most of the time of energy. And then we have reverberation, which is kind of the decay of energy, how long it takes the energy to get down to levels that we've already predetermined. So two different areas here we need to look at. Attack and decay rates also below 100 cycles are critical in our rooms, because that yields definition. A low frequency note should have the same kind of definition, separation, clarity, if you will, that the mids, maybe not the highs, but at least the mids have, because they're really related in the frequency spectrum. You need a tight defined low end in order for the mids to come through. It'll give you a foundation. It just adds more dimension to the sound state. So the attack and decay rates below 100 cycles in our rooms have to be managed correctly. Most of the products in the marketplace today cannot do that. They just don't. They may have level, but they don't have the rate of absorption necessary to achieve this. So anybody can build an absorber that goes down to 40 hertz. Getting it to absorb a lot of energy in a small amount of space is more difficult. So keep that in mind when you're looking at products. So our reverb times, what's an ideal reverb time in our room? What's an ideal time that we should use to manage all the reflections in our room and let that energy decay at a nice even rate? Usage dependent. We're not going to get into numbers here because we could argue all day long. Let's just put it this way. It's dependent on the usage. A control room, different than a live room. Live room, different than a listening room. All room usages, home theater, a little bit different. So all of these usages have different reverb times that are acceptable, highs and lows. What's liked between those is subjective. So you have to consider that also. So you have ranges and windows of acceptable times in the literature, but really what it boils down to is personal preference. So dial in within the range and then fine tune to personal preference. Attack and decay rates below 100 cycles, if managed correctly in your room, are really good for your sound stage. They really help fortify or bolster all the things that you've done on your sound stage. So a company that subscribes to this philosophy is JL Audio, and they do a really good job with producing a lot of energy, small amount of space. So attack and decay rates are definitely in the low end, good for the sound stage if you get them right. Reverberation times for the middles and highs mostly. But all of these things work together. So it's reflections and pressure, as always. Thank you. More to come. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give me a thumbs up so I know that it had value to you. And please, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section, and I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. Alternatively, if there are other topics that you wish to discuss or see discussed in a video presentation, send me an email, info@acousticfields.com, and we'll get them on our list and get them done for you. I release a new video about every week, so stay tuned to our YouTube channel and keep updated on our new videos.